Over several years, there have been efforts at the level of the European Union to establish common standards of safeguards and guarantees for a fair and efficient asylum procedure for efficient and fair decisions, thereof ensuring that all member states apply common and coherent high-quality standards when examining applications. In Ghana, the refugee program starts from the emergency phase, that is, reception, refugee status determination, and provision of assistance. When the emergency stage is over, the next phase a refugee is introduced to is the livelihood program, and then the final phase, which is the end stage where refugees are no longer refugees. The acting executive secretary of the Ghana Refugee Board, Mr. Tete Paddy, explained the Ghana model further.
There are activities that bring the refugee status to an end, which we call durable solutions. There are three of them. We assist refugees to return to their country of origin voluntarily, that's very important, in safety and in dignity. Or they locally integrate in the country of asylum, in this case Ghana. So again, we provide assistance for them to stay here legally as foreign nationals, which is the model that Ghana has adopted. Then the other option is for refugees to be resettled in a third country, which really is the prerogative of that third country. And so those are the three durable solutions.
The rights that people have vary significantly according to their legal status. Obtaining refugee status is often an individual process and can take several months or longer, depending on the country and the specific situation of the asylum seeker. While refugee status comes with a wide range of rights and often includes additional support measures such as language and courses, registered asylum seekers or people who have not yet submitted the asylum application may be subject to restrictions. These restrictions include being confined within the limits of a reception center, not being able to travel outside the municipality or the region, and not being allowed to work. However, the acting executive secretary of the Ghana Refugee Board, Mr. Tete Paddy, says regardless of the legal status, everybody is entitled to basic rights such as accommodation, food, healthcare, and education for children. For GBC News, Ofeyi Wadakon reporting.